tonight's lesson is going to be the second part of what we did yesterday. So it'll be my responses to the provocations from these swords crossed inside, inside, outside, outside. We will follow the same order as last time, starting with the outside, so we can falso con falso, and then finish with dritto con dritto. So I am in, preparing myself with my full sedge touching, so maybe they've done a punto reverso, and I've got my right foot, got my left foot, either is fine. The key difference being that if my left foot is forward, my right foot is going to do something followed by the left, whereas my right foot is forward, that's going to do, I don't say all of the work, but that's kind of the crux of it. So our first crossing is again someone who is going to cross here and throw a tondo to the head. So for the sake of simplicity, I'm going to do all of these with my right foot forward. So we are ended up here. And this is going to come, so I have one of two options here. I can either thrust to that face, thrust to the face in the face guard. I'm hitting him as he's coming around, which I have time to do. Or, so over here, bring that to the hand, slice through. It's really important this one that you wait until a cut is developed, because if you go too soon, you won't actually have anything to hit. So you need to be a little bit patient with this one, so you can place and draw. Our second one is the feint. So we've gone to here. They're expecting us to come over here so they can get us to this side. So I'm going to do this. That's my action. Person receiving. I want to start going this way, but I don't move my feet. So that allows me to step back. Maybe I'll hit the hand, maybe not, but I've defeated his intention at that point. So we're here, and we step back. It's important we don't freeze and don't stop. Alternatively, we could turn our hand. So we've got to here, as he's charging this, whether it's entry towards unicorn, somewhere there, depending on where the angle of his cut. But generally speaking, an entry position should work. Three is going to be when he comes with the imbroccata. I'm going to make the cover. He starts coming. I'm going to let it happen, step back, and hit the hand. So you notice a very, very small left triangle step here. Oops, sorry. Here. That's just allowing me to use my right foot. Four is when we lower the hand. So we'll come here, and I can be on top of them. So there's my agent's part. So when we're here, and they start drawing that down, I want to get out of there in one of two ways. So either I catch it early, and I go to a to thrust in that position. So here, he starts doing that. The second he starts, I turn my edge, or rather, turn my edge and thrust. Or, if I'm a little bit later here, he starts doing that. Because basically I bring the hand all the way up to alto, and come back down with a mandrillo squalimbro. So note that it's not a stramazzone, but it's a squalimbro. So I'm here. And big old elbow cut to that hand. Five's when he comes in with to seize my hand. I'm going to do the opposite of what we did in the version of the attacks. So as we're here, he comes in to seize. Do I cut out Finette to the head? Making sure that's a Finette. So we're right down the center. And then finally we have number six, which is when they subjugate slash the throat, cut around. So you know that whenever our sword is, oh sorry, that's the twist. So six here is when they drive our sword to the side, cut and cut, or drive a sword, thrust, leave. Against both of those things, we're just gonna step back with the Urbigasma Stamas on it, hopefully getting them in the hand. So we made this cover. That cover, in drop both, just step back with the Urbigasma Stamas on it. Now, as we get to the inside to inside, these are a little bit more intuitive, I find. So our first one is they're attacking us and stepping around. So all I do here is I evade my cover, they come around, I turn and step forward, or I step back with a Urbigasma Stamas on it, hopefully hitting the hand. So it's either round, or and again, most that small little left foot triangle to free up my right foot again. Two is when I do the snapping thrust over top. So pull to throw the mandrito and then I get the reverse. So here I'm just going to slip out of the way essentially, which allows me to throw a Urbigasma Stamas on it to interrupt their action. I'm not going to hit them, only be on the hand. The main goal here is to just not get hit by this unexpected angle of attack. Three is our feint. So they come in, give the look, snap this cut, tondo, mandrito. Here we have two options again, because of how long this action is going to take. So when I have come here, I'll start turning the hand, but I will not turn my body with my foot. So when they come, transition to face guard. Or, so we have come here, when they, oh sorry, so when we do that, we've done this, hit into the face, and I want to leave with a Urbigasma Squalibro. So all together, it's major initial defense, start going here, defend, step back with a Urbigasma Squalibro, or Stramazzone. Time, initial defense, open up, turn, step back. Four is when it's a continuation of one. This is where they are a little bit closer, so they're gonna hit with the hilt and step around. So when they hit that hilt, I'm gonna take that energy and go back with a dritto stramazzone. So defend, take the energy and go with it. Five is when they're even closer. So they hook with that pommel. I'm just gonna do the same thing back to them. So they've done, sorry, we've defended. As soon as I start, I will step around and throw my own reverso to their head. Finally, this leaves us with the subjugation. So they make the contact, subjugate, cut, and cut. I'm going to take the energy, the direction that they're pushing me in, and do our standard thing, which is a reverso stranzone. So I've defended, they're pushing me this way, I bring my hand up, and I step back. To make this a little bit more fluid, I want to use that triangle step just to allow my right foot to move again. So one and two. So some of these you'll see lead directly to a counterattack, to the hand, to the head, to the body. But a number of these are just getting myself some space, getting myself some time. So there we have it. There are, that is the end, if you want, you can really say that, of the sword in one hand material that I can show by itself. So the next videos will be on the companion weapons. I hope you enjoyed the series so far.